Hello, Dr. Allen here once again. We have completed both sagittal and horizontal sections of the brain, and we're going to move into the frontal brain blocks next. Remember, with the frontal section, we separate anterior versus posterior. So in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to start with the most anterior slices and work our way backward. And before I forget, if you're not sure what kind of slice you're dealing with, you do have a cheat on the blocks that we have in lab. So it will tell you what kind of section you're working with in case you're unclear. All right, we're going to begin here with block number 8, and we'll also do block number 5 because these guys are so far forward, somewhere up in here. They're so anterior. The only things that we'll really be able to identify are going to be portions within the cerebrum. So we won't be able to see midbrain, pons, or cerebellum, none of that fun stuff. And that's part of the reason I know this is more anterior. The cerebellum isn't in view. Anyway, in this view, I can take a peek at part of one of the lateral ventricles. This is the most anterior side. If I flip it over, I can now see both of the lateral ventricles easily. You can still see gray versus white matter, just like we've seen on other blocks. If we move over to block number 5, this is the more anterior side. I can see portions of the lateral ventricles. If I flip it over, I can now see even more of the lateral ventricles. I can still see white matter versus gray matter here as well. We'll look for the corpus callosum, insula, and other features on the other two brain slices.